special blessing upon them. We pray, oh God, for the superintendent of the Sunday school and the persons who assist her. May they not grow weary in well-doing. Raise up more persons in this congregation, in this fellowship, to assist also, because when we sow seeds in the young minds, Father, it will bloom. So, Father, as they go, we pray that you will bless them and bless us. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen. This will light up mine as I bless you. Go. Come on, man.
What shall I do with this do with these people. They are almost ready to stone me. The Lord said to Moses, go on ahead of the people and take some of the elders of Israel with you. Take in your hand the staff with which you struck the Nile and go. I will be standing there in front of you on the rock at Horeb. Strike the rock and water will come out of it so that the people may drink. Moses did so in the sight of the elders of Israel. He called the place Massah and Meribah because the Israelites quarreled and tested the Lord, saying, is the Lord among us or not? This is the word of God.
Thanks
be to God.
Amen.
In Psalm 78, verses 1 to 4 and 12 to 16. Please note the responses. Give ear, O my people, to my teaching. Incline your ears to the words of my mouth.
I will open my mouth in the parable. I will utter that sayings of old.
Things that we have heard and known, that our ancestors have told us.
We will not hide them from our children.
In the sight of their ancestors, he worked marvels in the land of Egypt, in the fields of Zoar.
He guided the sea and let them pass through it, and made the waters stand like an eagle.
In the daytime, he led them with a cloud, and all night long with a fiery light.
He spread frost open in the wilderness, and gave them drink abundantly as possible.
Together,
he increased the power of the rocks, and caused waters to flow down like rivers.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Spirit, made one, as it was in the beginning, is now and ever shone, the world without end. Amen.
One more time.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Spirit, made one, as it was in the beginning, is now and ever shone, the world without end. Amen.
You can sit and sing beneath the cross of Jesus. Just one verse.
Be of the same mind, having the same love, being in full accord and of one mind. Do nothing from selfish ambition or conceit, but in humility regard others as better than yourselves. Let each of you look not to your own interests, but to the interests of others. Let the same mind be in you that was in Jesus Christ, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness, and being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God also highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend, in heaven and on earth and under the earth. And every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Therefore, my beloved, just as you have always obeyed me, not only in my presence, but much more now in my absence, work at your own salvation with fear and trembling. For it is God who is at work in you, enabling you both to will and to work for his good pleasure. Yes.
Thanks be to God. Jesus is the rock on which I stand. Jesus is the rock on which I stand. I have now been assumed pastoral responsibility for Princess Song also. So you all could go if you all want. I hope you're coming on. But I'm under compunction, I'm under orders. I must go. Okay. Now, what does the gospel say to us this morning? We're going to look at the gospel according to Matthew chapter 21. What do we do for the gospel, my dear friends? You stand for those who are able. The gospel is according to Matthew chapter 21. We'll be reading from verse 23 through to verse 32. Matthew 21, 23 to 32. The source of Jesus' authority. Again, when he entered the temple, the chief priests and the elders of the people came to him as he was teaching and said, "By what authority are you doing these things? And who gave you this authority?" Jesus said to them, "I will also ask you one question. If you tell me the answer, then I will also tell you by what authority I do these things. Did the baptism of John come from heaven, or was it of human origin?" And they argued with one another. "If we say from heaven, he will say to us, 'Why then did you not believe him?' But if we say of human origin, we are afraid of the crowd, for all regard John as a prophet." So they answered Jesus, "We don't know." And he said to them, "Neither will I tell you by what authority I am doing these things." What do you think? A man had two sons. He went to the first and said, "Son, go and work in the vineyard today." He answered, "I will not." But later he changed his mind and went. Then the father went to the second and said the same. And he answered, "I go, sir." But he did not go. Which of the two did the will of his father? They said the first. Jesus said to them, "Truly I tell you, the tax collectors and the prostitutes are going into the kingdom of God ahead of you. For John came to you in the way of righteousness, and you did not believe him. But the tax collectors and the prostitutes believed him. And even after you saw it, you did not change your minds and believe him." Sisters and brothers, the gospel of Christ.
Praise
to
Christ, O Lord.
Halle, halle, halle. Jesus is Lord. to the glory of God the Father.
Yes.
Let us pray. Lord God, here we are this morning in your sanctuary, gathered as your people who call the name that is above every name, and at the call and calling of that name, every knee shall bow and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. We recognize, O Lord, that Jesus, your Son, lived our life. He knew our highs and our lows, our happy and our sad. He was tempted at all points as we are, but did not sin. It was Jesus, the same Jesus who called the church to be and sent it into the world on a mission to make your love known and your will shown. We pray that we may faithfully play our part in your continuing mission. So even now, as you have appointed me to declare a word in the hearing of your people, may the words of our mouths and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our God, our Redeemer, and our Sustainer. Amen. Amen. I just want to acknowledge the presence of Brother Brentwood and show you our prayers. But our prayers are with him and his family this time as they mourn the passing of the Lois. Fight one. And imagine a wonderful wife, a wonderful mother, a wonderful sister. I see Sister. Sister Noreen, you're hiding behind Brother Frederick. I see Sister Noreen, her last surviving sister. Yes. Sister Noreen, you're not alone, eh? It's you alone, but you're not alone, okay? We are with you, and God, even more importantly, God is with you. Friends, as early as Monday, God would have placed this word in my heart as I reflected on how we might be treating God and His Son, Jesus Christ. I thought about how we go about doing the Lord's work, and the time you're willing to spend engaging in activities that draw us closer to God and each other. You see, friends, we can stay at home and worship God enough, but it's also important to come together like this to worship God. It was a complaint. I think it is in the writing of the Hebrews. Do not refrain from assembling as some persons do. Was talking about the importance of coming together. I thought about also how it is that we just cannot seem to find time to do much concerning the things of God. And one of the things I wondered about was whether Jesus had sufficient impact on our lives. When we mention the name Jesus, what comes to our minds? When we talk, do we think that? Do we reflect on His goodness and His mercy? Do we think about what God has done for us through Jesus Christ? Does the name Jesus excite us? Or do we say it's just another name? In Jamaica they say Anana. It's just another name. But my friends, the name of Jesus is an important name. It is a rock. Jesus is a rock on which we stand. You see, my dear friend, let me tell you this. We cannot outdo Jesus. When Jesus was just about to bow his head on that old rugged cross, you know what he said? You know what he was said? It is what? Finished. So you can't do better than that. You cannot outdo Jesus. You cannot rework salvation. Salvation has been bought. It is full and it is free and it is complete. What we are doing, my friend, whatever we do for Jesus, we are just playing catch up. We cannot outwork or outserve Jesus. We are just playing catch up. So when you come, my dear friends, to worship, it's not what we're doing, it's who we're going to favor. You don't do God a favor, you know? You do yourself a favor because you allow yourself to give thanks and praise to Almighty God. If you're not grateful for what God has done, then you are ungrateful. And don't really have it, this thing, there's a saying, ingratitude worse than obey. Remember what I'm saying? Some people say witchcraft. If you cannot come to open your mouth to give God praise, you are ungrateful. It's as simple as that. Can I talk to you all? We must stop being ungrateful and feel that we're doing God a favor when we come to worship. God has already done everything for us. You cannot outdo what God has done for us through Jesus Christ. Now, I was thinking too. Persons have to experience what Jesus has done for themselves. Now, your grandmother could tell you about it, eh? Your godparents could tell you. But there comes a time when you have to know what Jesus Christ has done for yourself. It comes a time when your faith minister can lift you up and bring you to worship. He can lift you up and bring you to Bible study. He can't force Jesus down your throat. You have to experience it for yourself, you know. I don't get frustrated again, you know. When I come to Bible study and I see a few persons, I don't get frustrated. But I don't get as frustrated as I used to get. Because what I say is that persons have just not reached that level as yet, and we have to continue to pray for them. Those of us, my dear friends, who have experienced the goodness of God and we can't wait for the church door to open, we just have to continue pressing on. We can't give up and look back and say, why this one not coming and why that one not coming. We must know why we are coming. We are coming, you know, when you come to Bible study, they say, I am sharpened iron. Listen, I went to college for 4 years. Well, before that was local teacher's exam. Then I went to college seminary for 4 years to learn to divine the Bible, to learn to divine the word of God. And now, my going next year, only the third summer, doing further studies, learning to divine the word. But guess what? I don't know everything. When I come to Bible study, persons, my dear friends, when they say so many things that I never thought about before. So when you miss Bible, when you don't come to Bible study, you miss out. But what I'm saying, I know that we meet here on a Tuesday. Sometimes it's not convenient. So what I'm deciding to do, I'm trying to arrange, okay? So you can't come Tuesday, let us see if you can come Wednesday. You can't come in the evening, let us see if you can run away lunchtime. And if you can't reach here, let us see if you can reach you. That's the way of going, Sister Cynthia. We're not going to fuss ourselves. Bible studies on Tuesday evening, those who can make it, we are happy to see you. If you can't make it, and you can make it another time, like if you want, Tuesday is a good time for you, Wednesday is a good time for you, we meet at Pension. You understand? So we are going to fuss and fight. You must know the relationship you have with Jesus and what he has done for you. So you see, what we do as a community is by God's grace, what we seek to do, we seek to create opportunities for us to encounter the risen Lord. I mean, when Jesus rose from the dead, as recorded in the Gospel according to John chapter 20, he appeared to his disciples, where? In the upper room. You remember that story, that account? So he appeared to them in the upper room, and the first thing he did, he said, peace be unto you. And then the next thing he did, he showed them his pierced hands and he showed them his side. When they realized who it was, you know what they did? They rejoiced. But when Thomas, I don't know where Thomas was, when Thomas eventually appeared and they told Thomas that, Thomas, we have seen the Lord, he's arrived, he's alive. Thomas doubted them. He said, listen, you see me? I know all this thing. Unless I see with my own two eyes and put my fingers in his pierced hands and put my hand in his side, I will definitely not believe. 1 week after, on the first day, and listen, I'm emphasizing the first day of the week. On the first day of the week again, because that is when the Christians, the disciples gather to break bread. On the first day of the week, I'm emphasizing the first day of the week because persons will be confusing you all and telling you all that is not the day to worship. We must know why we're not going to argue with anybody as to which day is the best day to worship. We're not going to argue. What we're going to say is that you worship on this day because Christ died on that Friday. That's one day. They had a Saturday pass, and he rose again from the dead on the third day, which is the first day of the week. So we must just know why we worship on the day in which we worship. Don't hold any long argument. Just say, well, with all due respect, that is why we do what we do. So Jesus appeared the following week and said again, peace be unto you. And he showed, well, he pointed out Thomas. He said, Thomas, I didn't think I was here again. Well, come and put your hands in my nail pierced hands and come and put your finger in the side. Now, I do not know if Thomas actually went and put his finger where he said he wanted to put it and put his hand where he said he wanted to put it. All I know is that he said the highest praise, my Lord and my God. Friends, that's the highest praise you can give to Jesus. My Lord and my God. And that is the point, my dear friends, we all have to reach for ourselves. When we can say that, yes, thank grandma for telling me about Jesus. Thank mommy and daddy for telling me about Jesus. Thank Nene for telling me about Jesus. But I now know Jesus for myself. That is the point that we have to get at, my dear friends. So, if other persons have not reached that point, we have to be patient with them and pray that God, through His Son Jesus Christ, will reveal Himself to them. So that is it. My Lord and my God. I believe that that is where we have to reach in our experience of Christ. We have to come to the point where we can save ourselves. My God and my God. I want to present to you gathered here this morning, Jesus, the name above all names. And I want to share briefly from Paul's letter to the Philippians chapter 2 and verses 9 to 11, where Paul, using the words of a Christian name, therefore, God also highly exalted him and given the name that is above every name. So that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend in heaven and in earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. You see, in the early times of Christianity, the Romans, they were not only a strong military force, but they were dominating power in religion. They worshipped their emperor as a god. The people were allowed to retain their own religion as long as they accepted emperor worship, along with their own belief. So the Roman authorities didn't tell you that you can't worship your god, but once you also acknowledge the emperor as a god. So remember when some Herodians and some scribes, they came to Jesus to trick him, and they said, Rabbi, we know that you speak the truth. If it's wrong, you say it's wrong. If it's right, you say it's right. Tell me something. And they took out a coin. And they said, tell me something. Is it right to pay taxes to Caesar or not? And Jesus said, why are you tempting me? Let me see this coin. And he looked at it. He said, whose inscription is this? He said, the emperor. He said, well, if this is the emperor, render unto the emperor what belongs to the emperor, and render unto God what belongs to God. You see, if Jesus, whatever Jesus had said, they were ready to trap him. If he said, no, it's not right, they would say, we're going to charge you for sedition. And sedition was punishable by death. And if he said, well, it is right to pay taxes to Caesar. Then the Jews would say, you are no friend of ours. Go away. But Jesus put it squarely. Render unto Caesar the things that belong to Caesar, and unto God the things that belong to God. We have to know, my dear friends, where to draw the line. We want to worship politicians. You worship politicians? Politicians, my dear friends, they come a dime a dozen. When is every 4 or 5 years, they come to your house. They give out their manifestos. They tell you what they're going to do for you. They come in when election time finish. You have to go and try and find them. When they come into your house for the day, they get an appointment, you know. But after that, you have to make appointments. And the line is long. If you see their face, other than seeing them on the TV, you're lucky. So we have to know as Christians. Listen, we want to respect everybody's authority, you know. But we have to know we cannot put our faith and trust in them. So, the word, the Greek word kurios, meaning Lord, was used as a divine title for the emperor. This is the same word Paul used in speaking of Jesus as Lord. After the death and resurrection of Christ, God highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name. It is the name above every name, indicating that he is Lord. When we call Jesus Lord, we have to know what we're saying, you know. Are we really willing to treat him as Lord? You see, a day is coming when every knee will bow at his name and every tongue will confess him as Lord. One day, my dear friend, one day, as surely as night turns today, one day. But in the meantime, we are work. God is working his purpose out. God is working his purpose out. As year succeeds to year, God is working his purpose out. And what? The time is drawing near. Yet nearer and nearer draws the time. The time that shall surely be. When the earth shall be filled with the glory of God as the waters cover the sea. In the meantime, my dear friends, we continue to press on. We continue to endure because we know that the day is coming when every knee should bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. In the meantime, friends, though you can't hasten the day is in God's hands. One day Jesus said to his disciples, according to the Gospel of John chapter 13 and verse 13, he said, you call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for that is what I am. But I want to put it to you this morning that it is more than bending the knee and confessing of the lips that he desires. He wants the lordship of our lives. Jesus is more concerned that we confess him as Lord with our hearts than with our lips. The Isaiah complained on behalf of God. These people say, Lord, Lord, with their lips, but their hearts are far from me. You see, my dear friends, when we acknowledge Jesus as Lord, we recognize him as having ownership of our lives. In accepting his ownership, we must submit to his will. We must relinquish all rights to our lives and holding nothing back. You know, we want to tell God, you say, God, you see this part of our lives, you can touch it. But we have a little movie corner here, so we want you to kind of stroke a bit. Even like that. If you have a friend, my dear, to invite your friend to come to visit you, they're coming from far. They're coming from the city. They're coming to you for a month. And you carry them and you say, listen, you see, and you show them the house, they didn't know the house. You say, well, you see the living room? You can come into the living room anytime. But you see the dining room, you have to stay, you know, stay out a little. And you see this toilet here, this bathroom. You can use this bathroom. You see that fancy bathroom there, you have to stay out a little. And you see this porch. You can come on this porch, but you see the veranda that extends to the back, you have to stay out a little. Now, let me tell you what will happen. Yeah? Two things will happen. Oh, one thing will happen is that the friend will get a very urgent message. that somehow they have an emergency back home in the States and they have to leave tomorrow. And when they reach, if you hear from them again, God bless you. We want to treat God like that. Say, God, Lord Jesus, this room is yours. You can come here, but this other room here, you want to see out the door. Jesus Christ wants total authority of the place. He wants every key, even the key to your secret place. He wants to open the door and see what you're hiding there. So don't hold back. In other words, my dear friends, there must be no reservations. When we go into a business place, they might have employees only. Yes? Isn't that what you see in business places? Employer, assigned man, employees only? No. With Jesus, he must have the run of the place. He must tell you what to kick out, what to keep, and what to throw in. The evangelist Matthew, in his chapter, in chapter 16 and verse 24, just before he told them what I'm going to see now. Remember, Jesus asked him a question, recorded in Matthew 16 and verse 16, who do people say that I am? They said, some say Elijah, some say Jeremiah, some say John the Baptist, raised from the dead, or some other prophet. And then he said, now who do you say that I am? Asking the disciples. And Peter answering on behalf of the disciples said, you are the Messiah, the Son of the Living God. Remember that? And he said, bravo, Peter. Flesh and blood did not reveal that to you, but my Father in heaven. And anyway, God will say, listen, I say you are Peter, and on this rock, not Peter, on this rock, the statement that Peter made, you are the Messiah, the Son of the Living God, I will build my church, and the gates of hell will not prevail against it. And then he said, whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth will be loose in heaven. The authority. And then he began to tell Peter what this whole thing about discipleship means. He said, well, I'll be going to Jerusalem. The religious leaders will treat me very badly. I will be subject to a Kangaroo court. I'll be condemned to death. I will die. And Peter didn't wait to hear anything else. He grabbed Jesus by his head and said, far be it from you, Lord, that must never happen to you. And then the same person who Jesus just congratulated, he had to say, get thee behind me, Satan, for you acknowledge the things that are of the earth, and you do not acknowledge divine things. And then he said, in verse 24, if anyone wants to become my followers, let them deny themselves, take up their cross, and follow me. There's a translation of the Bible called Philip's Version, where this same verse is translated, if anyone wants to follow in my footsteps, he must give up all rights to himself and take up his cross and follow me. I want to ask you this question this morning. Now, I'm saying I want to ask you. I have asked myself the question, because before writing up the notes, before preaching the sermon, I have to preach it to myself first. So I'm saying, I'm asking you, I know what my answer is. I'm asking you this morning, who is the Lord of your life? Self or the Lord Jesus Christ? You see, just calling him Lord doesn't mean you are allowing him to be that. You and I must recognize his right to that place in our lives. Is he the Lord of your possessions? Is he the Lord in your homes? Is the name of Jesus glorified where you live? What about our time? How do we spend our time? How do we use our time? Do we use our time praising God, serving God? Or do we use our time for our own pleasure? What about our talents? Do we use it in the service of God? What about our career? Some of us are married to our jobs. What about our business? For we slave over the business. We accumulate all sorts of different things. And then guess what? How did that take us? And we have to leave everything right here. Have you released your family to him? Can we say, Christ Jesus, you are My Lord, the boy wants to preach me to my Lord. You are worthy to be praised, worshipped, and adored. There is none like you. You are the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. And you worship your Lord. Your Lord are worthy to be praised. Look at this. We have a lot of work to do. Sometimes you can feel so overwhelmed by the pressures of life. So much to do and so little time. I want us to claim, my dear friends, Pleasantville for Jesus Christ. I want us to go into that area again. I know you went into the area a few years ago and you really did some work. I want us, my dear friends, to go into Pleasantville again. For those who live in the back of there, find out if we can get the community center for at least a week or so. That area must be claimed for Jesus Christ. Members who live in the back of there, I'm seeing, my dear friends, a strong set of witnesses there. Gasparillo, Barbello, get ready, for Jesus is coming and we want you to acknowledge him as Lord. We want to claim those who make their homes on the promenade for Jesus. Friends, when Jesus is truly Lord in our eyes and our hearts will be open to see that everyone needs Jesus. Jesus is the name above all names. He is our Savior. So my dear friends, he is worthy to be praised. How great is our God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. May God bless us richly as we give Jesus the highest praise. Jesus, name above all names. Beautiful Savior, glorious Lord, Emmanuel, God is with us. Blessed Redeemer, living Word. Friends, will you stand with me as we sing Jesus? Name of our own names.
the name of our name.
Trinidad and behold.
Shout Jesus with me.
Jesus.
Jesus.
I want to thank God at this time because this brother, God has been speaking to him for some time. Many years ago we were at your house, Sister McLaren and myself. And since then I knew God's hand was upon me. So when you kept coming and speaking to me, I knew that God was dealing with you. And all that God was praying to you. And bring you to that place where God can use you. He hasn't started to use you yet. As you release yourself more and more into Him and submit yourself to Him, God will use you very tremendously. You have a sure word of God in your mouth that this world needs, the church needs to hear. And do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. Today, we bind the spirit of fear. There are many other people in this church that God is dealing with internally. And you hide. And you scamper yourself. You leave the church fast. Instead of staying after the service to hear what God has to say to you. At home you're terrified when God speaks in your heart. Because you don't know who to come to in the church. For verification and for praying you through into the place where God wants you. So, brother, I thank you very much that you dared to come to me. And God says that he will, the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. He is ordering your footsteps aright. And he has put me here and he's put another sister here for such a time as this. Because God wants an earthquake. If it will take an earthquake to shake you all into the place where God wants to be, Mexico is joke. He will shake this place. He will shake this place. He will shake this place. Until he has shaken somehow like ragdolls. And into the place that he wants you to be, male or female, for there is no gender with God. Let this day be a warning. Brother, I thank you for your obedience to God. And you didn't come once, you came twice to me this morning. And I knew when you came back the second time, there was an urgency in your spirit that God would not allow you to deny. So thank you, brother.
Then sings my soul, Lord God, for your mercies. We thank you for giving our brother the courage, because you have given us the spirit, not of fear, but a spirit of confidence, confidence in your Son, Jesus Christ. When you called a prophet Jeremiah, and he was afraid, you said, do not look at their faces. I have given you a word. We thank you for the obedience of our brother. We bless you, Lord God, for our sisters who are here at the altar this morning. Father, you know exactly why they are here. Father, one of the reasons must be that they want to again recommit themselves to your Son Jesus Christ, who at whose name every knee shall bow and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Father, we want to pray, God, that in their individual capacities you will use them for your honor and your glory. At whatever stage you're at, O Lord God, we pray that you will lift them higher. We pray, Lord God, you will bring them to that point, and every one of us to that point where we see that we yield completely to you, O Lord God. And so, Lord God, we pray for our sister, pray that you just continue to bless her. Thank you, Lord God, for bringing her back to these shores safely after spending many years away, and Father, she can come and she can spend time with her a mother, minister to a mother at this particular point in time, her other siblings and her children and her grandchildren. We pray that you just continue to bless and keep her, O Lord God. May there always be an aching in her heart that she wants more of your Son, Jesus Christ. And Father, those who ask, you will in no wise turn out. So Father, we pray that you just continue to bless in a very special way, God. Eternal Father, we want to pray for your sister, Lois. We pray, O God, that she will continue to bless your name and acknowledge what you have done in her life, O Lord God. She is now, she has joined the ranks of widowhood. But we know, Lord God, that you are with her. We pray, O God, that she will continue to be strong in the faith, that she will never grow weary of well-doing, that she will never be afraid of proclaiming your name. Father, the name is Jesus, the only one. And so, Father, we pray that she will learn to lift him up even higher in her life. Bless her children, bless her friends, bless all those, O Lord God, who continue to remember her and to call her and to really assure her of your presence. In Jesus Christ we pray. Amen. Father, we thank you for dear sister Carol, who has been away for some time. We thank you, O Lord God, that she has been away but is back with us, sing our song. We pray that you continue to bless her, O Lord God. We pray that she will continue to be faithful to you. You know why she is here. And Father, we pray, Lord God, that even as she continues to give herself more of you, you will continue, Lord God, to assure her of your love and your grace. Father, bless Susan. Father, we bless you for Susan. We bless you, Lord God, for the little bundle of joy that she has. And Alicia, we pray, Lord God, that you will continue to bless that family, Lord God. Draw them closer to you and closer to each other. We pray that the name of Jesus Christ will be lifted up in the home, O Lord God, of all these persons, including Susan. And so, Father, we ask that you just hear our prayer and let these our cries come unto you. We pray these things in no other name but the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Lord. Amen. So sisters, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you. The Lord be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and grant you his peace. Amen.
My God, I know I feel in mind and will not quit my thing. The Lord I have, Lord, I was not in man. Amen.
Then sings my soul. If you don't play your part, somebody else will play it, my dear friends, because God is even able to take the rocks that are on the ground and raise them up as a witness unto Him. Invite us to stand as we join the prayer of commitment. Remember, Lord God, that you loved the world so much that you sent your Son.
Remember that Jesus loved us so much that he was willing to die.
Remember that Jesus' disciples were marked off by their love for each believer and others. We pray that we may live up to our calling for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We go into a flow of faith in God as we repeat the words of the Nicene Creed. Together, we believe in one God, the Father the Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the Holy Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God of the world, life from life, true God from true God, begotten not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us human beings and for our salvation, he came down from heaven by the power of the Holy Spirit. He became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was born in human being. For our sake, crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, who proceeds from the Father, and who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Amen.
Please be seated. Lord, pray that you continue to bless us as we continue, as we renew our fellowship with you and with each other. We pray, Lord God, for those who are hurting, for those, Lord God, to whom God is speaking, to whom you are speaking to, God. Make yourself manifest in their lives. May we be willing and ready to hear from them a word, whether it is in season or out of season. Your name is to be praised and glorified at all times. Make yourself manifest to us, O God, in whatever way you choose. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Alright, so in case we have to reduce, Let us sing the Mother Benji.
Yeah.
Mother of Brentwood Moore, Marielle Benjamin Moore, and others.
the mother-in-law of Sister Catherine Moore, and others, and the great-grandmother of member in training, Mikai Moore, and others. The funeral service for Dolores Moore takes place this Thursday at 1 p.m. right here at San Fernando. So let us please remember all the bereaved in our prayers. The South Trinidad Circuit Praise Cruise, which took place on September 25th. We would like to say thanks to all those who supported the event in one way or the other. It was really a truly wonderful evening. Some persons who weren't able to attend, they were able to purchase tickets and give to friends and young people, so we also appreciate that. We are asking that those persons who have any outstanding funds to kindly submit by this Friday. Point 14 Methodist Church, they'll be having their lunch fundraiser on Thursday, the 12th of October, from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. And the menu would be curry crab, provision and dumpling for $50, and also shrimp pilau for $45. I never had shrimp pilau, but I would like to definitely try that. Alright, so interested persons could contact any one of the stewards for tickets. The proceeds from that event will go towards the church building expansion, the Sunday school, homework center, and the adult skills training program. Chaplaincy to schools, there is an appeal for persons to assist with the chaplaincy program at our preschool, San Fernando Methodist, Princess Dom Methodist, and the Wesley Preschool. Such persons would be asked to lead the school population in devotions once per week, and also to visit the institution from time to time to share the word of God. Interested persons are asked to contact Reverend Sam or Sister Humphrey. Faisalabad Methodist Church will be having their youth quick on October the 18th from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. It promises to be an inspiring and spirit-filled day, so we want to encourage all young people to support and attend youth quick. Just a reminder of some upcoming meetings. Thursday at 6 p.m. we have the Circuit Mission and Evangelism. Saturday, 7th October at 10 a.m. we have the Circuit Resources and Development Meeting right here in San Fernando. Saturday, October the 14th from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. Circuit Pastoral Council Meeting. And on that same Saturday the 14th from 1:30 to 3:30 we have the Circuit Council Meeting. Alright, so please take note of those dates. If you all need clarification in terms of who has to attend those meetings, you could see any one of the stewards afterward. Rescheduling of the San Fernando Congregational Council meeting is on Monday. Is that tomorrow, Reverend? Tomorrow? Right. So tomorrow at 6 to 8 p.m. So that's the San Fernando Congregational Council meeting. Takes place tomorrow from 6 to 8 p.m. right here. The retreat for prospective candidates for the ministry takes place in Barbados from October the 12th to the 15th. Interested persons are asked to speak with one of the ministers to indicate their willingness to attend no later than this Tuesday. In response response to the recent hurricanes, a special offering will be collected next Sunday, October the 8th, and also on the 15th in all congregations throughout the circuit for those who would have suffered throughout those hurricanes. We are asking for non-perishable supplies and also cash, well, cash will be collected, and also we're asking for the non-perishable supplies. So that will be next Sunday and the following Sunday. We continue to lift up in prayer all those who were affected by these recent hurricanes. These are all the notices I have for this morning. We will now have the tithes and offerings.
And
Reverend St. Gustav and Reverend Sister Daphne Machado. Did I say his Marie? How come? Oh, Sister his Marie. Yeah? Me, sorry, yes. And I got my notes, my friends. Most of the people I haven't called. I will, and I haven't seen, I will call you to remind you. Yeah. Well, I'm not saying. I know I called his name. The others know themselves. There was a mix-up on. There was a mix-up on Thursday. You know, you will plan out the day. You will plan out the day. But everyone will know that you will plan out your day. So on Thursday, I went to spend about, I went to look for another 5. And then at the office, when I was preparing for the meeting, I got a call from a very special person, Brother Printwood, who told me that his mother had passed. Now, if I'm able to, what I normally do when something like that happens is that I go to the home as quickly as possible, and we have a prayer meeting with the family right there and then, while the body was there. So that was what happened on Thursday. So when I came back on Thursday, the time that I would have spent preparing, I was, I think, about 5 minutes late. And some persons felt that the meeting was called off. So I apologize for giving that impression, but the church's car was in the yard, and the lights were on upstairs in the office. So I'm sorry for persons who thought that there was nothing going on. Okay? We're going to engage in some prayers of intercession. We're going to remember, think about the word after each intercession. I will pray, Lord, hear us. And your response will be, Lord, gracious. Let us reflect on what's happening in the world. We'll talk about the Caribbean later on. But what's happening in the world? We are thinking about this fact that is going on between the United States of America and North Korea. Now North Korea has nuclear weapon. They tested ever so often. But what we're going to pray for is that God will give the leaders wisdom and strength not to be tempted to press that button and put all of our lives in danger. Father in heaven, you are the author and finisher of all things. You lift up one and you put down another. None can tell you hold your hand or ask you what you are doing. You are God. Give wisdom to the leaders in those places where there is conflict and where persons are threatening each other across the Atlantic and across the various seas. We pray, Lord God, that they will act with restraint, wisdom, and compassion. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Remember, O Lord God, the Caribbean region, Father, where many territories have been devastated by the advent of hurricanes. We pray especially, O Lord God, for the people in Dominica. We pray for Barbuda. We pray, O Lord God, for those persons in Puerto Rico. For those in Panguila, other persons who have suffered at the hands of the hurricanes. And Father, passing very quietly was the earthquake that took place in Mexico. Amidst the storms and the hurricanes that were ravaging some territories in the Caribbean, almost very quietly, a number of persons lost their lives in Mexico because of our good faith. Father, we ask that you will give us grace, give us, O Lord, for the compassion to reach out to those who are in need as they seek to build back their life. We pray, O Lord God, for the offering that will come in next Sunday and the following Sunday. We pray, O Lord God, that it will be something of worth where we can send it on to those most affected. Bless the dealers in those areas, and pray, O Lord God, that the other leaders will form in the area will form a chain of support for them. Lord, hear us.
Lord, have mercy. Yes.
We are home now, Republic of Trinidad and Tobago, and we are on the eve of the budget presentation. Father, we present to you this country, the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. We ask, O Lord God, that you would bless the leaders, especially the President, the Prime Minister, the leader of the opposition, the one who is responsible for crafting the budget, that is the Minister of Finance, for all the other parliamentarians, the opposition bench, who will eventually have to respond. We pray that there will be proper dialogue, O Lord God, and that some kind of agreement will be able to be reached as to how best to go forward. So Father, into your hands we commit the proceedings for tomorrow and the following and the following days to come. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We think about educational institutions. There is so much work to be done, Lord. We pray that persons will rise up as chaplains to our institutions under the auspices of the Methodist Church. But Father, we know there is a further vision to go into the secondary schools and especially to minister to those persons who have passed through the Methodist school system and also those persons who belong to our church and who are attending these secondary school institutions. We pray, O Lord God, that persons will see how important it is to minister to these persons at this particular point in time in their lives. And so, Father, we pray and we know, O Lord God, that whatever is declared in your name, the word will not be turned void, but will accomplish that for which it has been put us. Lord, hear us.
Our
children and you. Father, we pray for the children and young people in this country in general and in our churches in particular. We pray that they will be able to stand up for what is right, that they will not succumb to peer pressure to do what is wrong. That they themselves will be light and will be able to encourage others positively to do what is good and right. Pray for those who need them. We ask, O Father, that you will give us the words to say and the deeds to do so that they can be encouraged to turn their lives over to Christ sooner rather than later. Lord, hear us. Despite this out of your hearts, you may bring your own petitions to Almighty God. Died after a period of illness. Pray, O Lord God,
and remembering a very special day. The family of the late Sister Dolores Owen and more needy, pray for her husband Owen. Thank you for the care that you took of us. Thank you for the caregiver Paula. Thank you, Lord God, for the son of the ground, Brother Brentwood, who was here and his wife. We thank you, Lord God, for Marion, his nurse sister, who was able to appoint the minister of Sister Lloyd. We pray for her sister, her remaining sister, Maureen. Pray, Lord God, that she will be comforted to know that she's not alone. We are with her, and especially you are with her. So Father, bless all those who mourn. And Father, we pray that we'll be there to comfort them. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
The Lord's Prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, that thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We are getting ready, my dear friends, to celebrate what God has done for us through His Lord, through His Son, Jesus Christ, as we sing the communion hymn, by Christ. By Christ restored. And during the singing of the hymn, the offering for the care fund will be taken. Whatever we have given, O Lord God, may it be used to meet a need or those who are finding it even more difficult than us to make two ends meet. So into your hands we commit ourselves and what we have given, so that we will be used, O Lord God, to honor you by taking care of our brothers and our sisters. In the name of Jesus Christ we pray. Amen. If you're offering a gift upon the altar, says Jesus, and dare you remember that a brother or sister has sinned against you, Jesus says, you must go and be reconciled to your brother or your sister, then come, return to the altar with your gift. In that spirit of forgiveness, compassion, understanding, and love, let us exchange with each other the right hand of peace. The peace of the Lord be with you. You have 2 minutes. I thought my eyes were deceiving me. I looked, And then, hardly ever, Brother Ivan, sorry that I didn't make you out. But welcome, welcome, welcome. When I went to shake his hand, I said, Brother, this is you? We thank God for his mercies. Those of you who know Brother Ivan, his hand is always there. And now he's actually here. Yes. And that is a miracle, friends. You know, we think of miracles as very, you know, big things. But that is a miracle. Because I was thinking either this week or next week to go and visit him at a certain place. But he has visited us. So Brother Ivan, welcome, eh? Yes. When I saw Brian, I almost cried. That Brian was crying. I said, bring on your fucking car. We're going to have a feast this morning. Hallelujah. But God bless you. But you know, listen. In terms of his job, it's a really a serious responsibility. And we pray that God will continue to give him the grace that he will be able to do that project and complete it and get accolades too. Okay? So when our people do well, it is as if we are doing well to rejoice. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It's a good, pleasant thing, joyful and salutary, always and everywhere to give you thanks and praise. The Lord God ever living, ever blessed, almighty, all loving. Through Jesus Christ, your only Son, our Lord, you created all things and made us in your image. And when we had fallen into sin, you gave him to be our Savior. He shared our human nature and lived a fully human life. He suffered rejection and condemnation and died on the cross. You raised him up from the dead and you exalted him to the glory of your right hand, where he reigns forever as priest and king and makes intercession for us. In witness of his glory and honor, you pour out the Holy Spirit, building up many people into one body, making us living members of your holy church, and enabling us to stand before you to sing your praises and celebrate your mighty acts. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we join the hymn of everlasting praise. We stand and we proclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed are you, Lord God, King of the universe. And blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who on a night in which he was betrayed, the bread into his holy hand, and looking up to heaven, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this and eat it. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after the supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it to them, saying, drink from it, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me.
Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Therefore, Father, in obedience to his command, we do this in remembrance of him. Pray that you will accept our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Grant that by the power of the Holy Spirit, we who receive your gifts of bread and wine may share in the body and blood of Christ and become united with him. And as we offer ourselves to you as a living sacrifice, we pray that you will bring us with your whole creation to your heavenly kingdom. This we pray through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom you, O Father, in the unity of the Spirit, be all honor and glory from all who dwell on earth and in heaven throughout the ages of ages. Amen. The bread that we break is a sharing in the body of Christ.
Amen.
The cup of blessing that we bless is a sharing in the blood of Christ.
Amen.
Though we are many, we are one body, because we share the one loaf and partake of the same drink. Let us pray a prayer of access together. Lord, we come to your table, trusting in your honesty, and not in the goodness of our own. We are not worthy to have a promise of condemnation, but it is your nature always to have mercy and die in prayer. So feed us with the covenant and blood of Jesus Christ, your Son, that we may forever live in him and hear us. Amen. Members of other congregations and other communions are also invited to share the Lord's Day with us. You who truly and sincerely repent of your sins, I love and shine with your neighbors and have resolved to lead a new life following the commandments of God, and by the power of the Spirit walk in his holy ways, draw near with faith. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you, and his blood which was shed for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. All is ready. Come and die.
Thank you.
final prayer of thanksgiving, we join together. We thank you, Lord, that you have fed us in the sacrament, united us with Christ, and given us the fullness of the heavenly banquet prepared for all mankind. Amen. Dear Brother Hector, for assisting in the communion, I want to invite those persons who would have been, who are going to be celebrating with us, to come at this time. Brother Benji, who is 14 years old, it's a joy. There's little Dustin. We pray. Amen. Lord bless and keep you, the Lord make his face to shine upon you, Lord be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and grant you his peace, now and forevermore. Amen. Lord bless you. We continue to pray for God's presence and endurance as we sing the closing hymn. God. We thank you, dear God, for allowing us to spend these moments in your sanctuary. We thank you for the fellowship that we encounter, and we thank you for the fellowship that we enjoy. And as we get ready to go from this place, O Lord God, may we go rejoicing, knowing that you are with us. Now the God of peace, who brought again from the dead, our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep of the blood of eternal covenant, keep you perfect in every good thing to do his will, working in us that which is well pleasing in his sight. Through Jesus Christ, who will be in glory forever and ever. The peace of God which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, rest with and abide with us all, now and forevermore. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
See you at Mrs. Down.